What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the Lost Cities mod in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Are you sick of vanilla Minecraft and its boring buildings? Do you wish your Minecraft world was a little bit more realistic? Are you looking for the hustle of a big city? If so, the Lost Cities mod is definitely for you. Not only does it immerse you in a large cityscape, but it adds different loots and dangerous mobs to test your skills. If you're interested in conquering the big city, then let's go over how to set up this mod. Visit the Lost Cities CurseForge page and then press Files at the top to view all of the available downloads. Scroll down and find the version that you want to download, and then you can use the download button on the right-hand side. Save this file to a safe location like a separate folder because we will need it again in just a minute. First, we are going to install the mod on your client. You're going to want to make sure Forge is installed, which we have a guide to that will be linked down below. After that, open your Minecraft launcher and then head to the Installations tab at the top, and then hover over your Forge profile and click the Open Folder icon on the right. In the new window, find or create a mods folder and enter it, and then paste your new mod jar file here, and then head back to the launcher. Next, you're going to want to head to your Apex server panel and then stop server and scroll down to the game file section. Make sure the panel is running a matching version of Forge to the mod that you downloaded, and then afterwards you can enter the FTP file access on the left-hand side, and then find or create a mods folder here and enter it. Press upload in the top left, and on the next page, you can drag and drop that mod file into upload. Once it is 100% done, you can click on your server name at the top of the page to return to the main panel. Now, before the Lost Cities will actually work on your server, we are going to have to configure your world to run the mod. If you have a version of 1.12.2 or earlier, you are going to go to your Apex panel, make sure the server is still offline, and then in the left-hand menu, enter into the config files. Select server settings, and then scroll down to the level type field and enter Lost Cities. If you are running Biomes Aplenty, then you're going to want to enter Lost Cities _BOP to enable it. After that, scroll down to save the changes, choose to create a new world, and then follow the prompts to restart the server. If you chose a version of 1.14.4 or later, then you're going to have to configure your world in your single player game first. From the main menu, create a new single player world, and then choose your desired world type, and then press Cities in the top right. Here, you can choose a profile template, or you can choose to customize it. Press Done when you're finished, and then continue to create the world. When you're done with that, you can head back into the Minecraft launcher, and head to Installations, and click that same Open Folder button from before, and then enter the Saves folder in the new window. Next, we are going to have to upload this world onto your server. I'll go over a quick version today, but we also have a more detailed guide that will be linked down below. Once you're in that saves folder, you're going to find your world and then zip that folder, and then connect to your server using an external FTP program, and then upload the world zip file until it's fully completed. After that, you can head back into your Apex panel and make sure the server is offline and head into the FTP file access. Find that zipped file, checkmark it, and then press unzip in the top right. Once the unzip is complete, you can head back to the main panel page again, and then scroll down to the Change World section, and make sure to enter the name of the uploaded world folder. Finally, once that's done, you can restart the server to load up the map. When you spawn into your world, you should pretty quickly notice large cityscapes covering the world. The size and the distance of these cities will change between your configuration settings, but what you can do in them tends to stay the same. Of course, the main thing that you're going to be able to do is explore. While there are many buildings that are scattered across the cities, there are also many open areas and walkways to navigate. You're going to be safe in the outdoor areas during the day, but at night is when things start to get a bit more dangerous. If the night spawning enemies aren't enough, a lot of the abandoned buildings are filled with mob spawners, which means danger will lurk around every corner. And I mean every corner. Some of the spawners are even hidden inside of the flooring, meaning that you could walk into a trap without even realizing it. If you're looking for a high-risk, high-reward transportation method, then the underground subway system is going to be your best bet. The tracks will often connect between cities and are almost always powered on by default. The underground area is mostly unlit though, so be ready to face mobs waiting in the darkness. Of course, none of this would really be worth it if you weren't getting something in return. The buildings within the cities will often have chests of various loot. While some might be empty or have small loot, others can carry the jackpot, so it's really all about exploring until you find exactly what you need. This is a great option to get tools early or avoid mining for hours. It might be a dangerous feat, but the rewards that these lost cities can give you make it all worth the risk. And of course, while the mod is great on its own, there are also tons of mods that you can add to it to do things like simulate a zombie apocalypse or just simply improve the survival gameplay. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.